Hi there, I'm Ashlyn with Fixed VIT. Today I want to talk about how to properly use multi-factor authentication, MFA for short, and how to avoid falling victim to new MFA-focused cyber attacks. If you want to skip to a specific part of this video, you can hover over the progress bar below and select the chapter you need. Now, let's get started. To start, let's walk through how to use multi-factor authentication properly. I already have it enabled on my Microsoft Office account, but if you don't, your IT provider can assist in that process. If you want to put MFA on personal accounts, there are plenty of tutorials online on how to do so. It only takes a couple of minutes to set everything up. In order for MFA to work, I will need two devices, like a laptop and a phone. And that's what I have with me today. When I try to log in on my laptop, an MFA prompt will appear on my phone. So I need to make sure I have the correct authenticator apps on my phone. I actually have multiple authenticator apps, like the ones for Google and Microsoft, since different websites require different apps. Today, though, I'll be using the Duo Authenticator app. Okay, let's log into my Office 365 account. Right now, we're looking at my laptop screen on the login page. I'll type in my username and complex password and sign in like normal. We've passed the first layer of security already with this login page. Now I need to get through the second layer of security by verifying that the login attempt was actually me. To do so, I will open up the prompt that appeared on my phone, as you can see on the right of the screen over here. This opens up my Authenticator app. Now we see a page with some information on what, when, and where the login attempt is coming from. This type of validation is a simple confirm or deny. So I will go ahead and confirm that it was me, and just like that, we're signed into my Office 365 account. After a couple more times of doing this, it becomes really quick. Now there are a few different types of MFA prompts. The first one we saw was a simple deny or confirm. There are also MFA prompts that require you to enter a time-sensitive string of numbers. It's similar to the codes you receive via text message when you reset passwords or something similar. However, we strongly recommend choosing MFA app verification over text message verification, since it's much easier for hackers to gain access into your text messages. Now that we've learned how to use MFA, it's time to talk about how malicious actors will try to trick you into approving prompts and handing over MFA codes. This is becoming increasingly common. As quickly as we adapt and find new ways to protect ourselves, attackers are finding new ways around those protections. Don't underestimate how far they will go in order to trick you. My first tip is never approve an MFA prompt that you did not initiate. You might randomly receive a prompt from your MFA app, even though you didn't sign into anything. This means that someone has gained access to your username and password and is trying to gain access into your account. Never approve this prompt. Instead, deny access and immediately change your password. If it's a business account, tell your IT provider as soon as possible. You won't get in trouble. If anything, it'll save time, money, and hours of headache if a breach were to occur. Another method malicious actors will use is spoofing, where they pretend to be your IT, bank, or even your boss in an attempt to get your MFA prompts and codes. Never share your MFA codes, especially if you receive a request out of the blue. They may also pretend to be selling something on Craigslist, Facebook Marketplace, or another similar site and ask for a verification code to confirm you're a real person. What they're actually doing is trying to get you to share your MFA validation code in order to gain access into your accounts. It's a convincing scam, but never share MFA codes you receive, ever, with anybody. My last tip is to stay vigilant and aware. Review every MFA prompt you receive, even if you think it's correct. Verify the account, time, and login location for every MFA prompt that pops up. If you aren't paying attention, you could accidentally approve a login for a different account, which means opening the door for attackers compromising your account. I know it seems like there's a new step to cybersecurity every day. Multi-factor authentication might seem like a waste of time or an unnecessary extra step, but that couldn't be further from the truth. With cyber attacks growing increasingly common, increasingly expensive, and increasingly dangerous, we all have to do our part to keep our businesses and selves safe. MFA is the new standard for logging in, and it only takes a couple more seconds of your time. And that's all I have for you today. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and check out our other videos on MFA and cybersecurity. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to comment below or reach out to our team at fixedvit.com. Thanks for watching.